Good morning. We are going to construct some new vector spaces. This is some aspect which is usually not done. Let us try to see. Okay. And on the way or at the end, we will exhibit some esoteric examples. Usually they are showcased as a parlor game in books or in classrooms. You'll see how you can actually generate those things. Okay, let us start sharing the screen and start our work. Right. So we had already seen, if I look at X is any set, X is any non-empty set, and let V be the set of all functions from X to R. Okay, we will call it a very notation, F of XR. This stands for all functions from the set X to R. Okay, we have seen this is a vector space over R. Okay, we gave all the details in the second lecture, right? Okay, now we can, if you really go through that verification, you will see we never use the fact R is a field, in the sense that whatever we did was essentially to do with vector space structure of R over R. You understand this? Remember, Rn is a vector space over R. In particular, when n equal to 1, R is a vector space over R, right? What all we needed to prove this Fxr is a vector space over R is we made use of the fact R itself is a vector space over itself. So when I multiplied, I thought of as a scalar multiplication, okay, of some real number by the vector real number, okay, of a vector. So if I think of t times x, where t I think of a scalar, x as I think of a vector, this I thought of, not even though it's defined as a multiplication of two real numbers, this I thought of scalar multiple of x by the scalar t. Okay, okay. If you get confused, don't worry. We will give a very quick and concrete example so that you'll know. Okay, now fix once and for all a vector space V over R. Could be finite dimensional, okay, could be anything. I should not use the word finite dimensional, we have not said it yet. Okay, right, be any vector space. Now let me look at the set of functions. Again, X is a non-empty set. Set of functions from X to, not to R, now to V. You understand that? This is set of all functions from X to V. What is V? V is a vector space. Okay, is this non-empty? Why this is non-empty? Because let's look at the thing, F of X equal to, remember, V is a vector space. Therefore, V always has one element. And what is the element? Obvious element. What we call theta or zero. The zero vector, right? Therefore, for all X in X, if I define F of X equal to theta, then this F is in this space. Therefore, it is non-empty. Okay, this is the zero function if you want to think of it. But remember, the function takes values into vector spaces. Therefore, you call V as a vector-valued function of the on X. Now, suppose I have two such functions F and G. How do you think I will define F of X V? How to define F G? Notice that I want to define an addition on this set. How do you think I will define? It must be a function from X to B. Therefore, if you start with any X in capital X, then F plus G, its value at X must be a vector in B. Do you remember? This is the way I argued with R also. How did I define this then? Obvious. How did I define? We define F plus G at X equal to Fx plus Gx. Do you understand this? take some time, understand. What is this fx? Fx is a vector in V. Gx is a vector in V. Now I know how to add two vectors in V. This is therefore, this is a vector in V. Is that okay? So we have shown that we can define addition. And similarly, I want to define a scalar multiplication. Suppose T is a scalar and F is a thing. I want to define T dot F. This must again be a function from X to V. Therefore, T dot F at a point X must be a vector. What is that vector? This is T dot Fx. Do you understand what the right side means? The Fx is a vector in V, T is a scalar in V, therefore T dot Fx will be a vector in V. So that is our definition. So what do you think I have defined? On Fx or Fx or Fx V, I have defined an addition and also a scalar multiplication. Now what is that I have to check? It satisfies all the properties. That is P1 to P4 and S1 to S4. Yeah? Just for fun, let's do one of the two things, right? We know that if I take my theta, then F plus theta is F. Where theta is as we did, okay? We will call this again theta, sorry. Okay, then I have to define. So let me call theta, okay? Theta is a function from X to V. That's what I did earlier. Theta of X is theta. This is theta is a zero vector of V. Okay, I am using the same notation theta for both sides. Okay. So instead of saying students will get confused, it's better they get confused when things are very easy. Once you come out of that, you will know. This is just a symbol. The context will make it clear. So this theta, if you want, I can also write capital theta. This is the capital theta. So capital theta at X by definition is theta. This is a zero vector in V. This is true for all X and X, right? Now, what I want to check? I want to check F plus capital theta is F. How, when are these two functions equal? That we already know. That is F plus capital theta at X. I want to check whether it is equal to Fx. This is for all X and capital X. But what is the definition of F plus theta X? That is F of X plus capital theta of X. Okay. I have to check whether it is equal to Fx, right? But what is Fx? Fx is Fx. But what is theta x? Fx is a vector in V. Theta x is the zero vector theta in V. And what do I know about this? This is just Fx. So equality holds. You understand? Right. Now let's look at additive, the inverse. So F is in F of XV. I want to know whether there exists a G from X to V so that F plus G is theta. What is the theta? This is a capital theta if you want. Right? How will I find this? Again, we work backwards. We will try to find. So this equality holds if only F plus G at X must be equal to theta of X. But what is F plus G at X? That is Fx plus gx. This is equal to the theta. Theta of x is theta. Now fx is a vector in V. Theta x gx is a vector in V. Therefore, how will I define g of x? Okay. This is the additive inverse of fx. Okay. Since V is a vector space, this is a vector in V. I know there is a vector which is additive inverse of this vector. That vector is what we denote by. Remember that if you use a vector in V, then there is a unique vector V in V, so that U plus V is the zero vector theta. This V is what you denote by minus U. Therefore, Gx is minus Fx. You follow that? Okay. Similarly, you can check all other things. So I leave it as an exercise. Okay. Please check. You have checked it from all real valued functions on a set. Now you have to check all V valued, that is vector valued functions on X. V is a fixed vector space. It's not changing. Okay. So if you do that, you will for sure know how to check all these things. Okay. So check or verify. Okay. Pause. review, proceed. PRP. Okay. So, how many vector spaces we can construct? Okay. You know already some exams of vector spaces. Now you start with any set X. Therefore, look at all functions from X to the vector space. They will form a vector space. Yeah. So that way we can construct lot of vector spaces. Now let us just time for some fun. Okay. Now let's look at the set singleton set which consists of only this element. You understand that? Now I want to make this into a vector space. The aim is make B a vector space. Isn't it fun? So you should know mathematics how to deal with that. Now what does it mean? Let's try to understand. To make V is a vector space, first I have to define a map from V cross V to V. That means give me any ordered pair of elements from V. But how many ordered pairs are there? There is only one ordered pair, namely. So I have to define this equal to what? Notice that if this must be a vector in V, this must be an element of V, but there is only one element of V. Therefore, how should I define this? I should define this to be this. Okay, this humanoid plus this humanoid, it must be the same humanoid. You understand this? There is no other way. You follow that? If it has to lie here, then it has to be this. Okay, now how will I define scalar multiple? R cross B to V. Again, what does it mean? You are going to give me T and you are going to give me a humanoid. Where should it go? It should go to T times humanoid. But where should this be? This be in the set V. Therefore, but in V, there is only one element, namely this fellow. Therefore, I have to define this. Therefore, T dot is this. That's it. You understand? Now, you have to check whether all the 8 properties are true. Right? So, is it commutative? Of course, yes. Associative meaning what? This plus this plus this. But this plus this is this plus this. But this is equal to this. Yeah? Or if you put a bracket this way, then this comes here, this two bracket comes like this. So again, the result is the same. You understand? Now, what is additive identity? So, given any vector in V, okay, you gave me, I have to find some vector in V so that's equal to the null vector, right? What is the null vector? Oh, I have not defined null vector, okay. Now, I want to find a theta so that this plus theta equal to this. And where should this fellow be? He must be in V. But there is only one element left for me, namely, therefore the theta must be equal to the humanoid. I follow that? And what is the additive inverse? Namely itself. So if you are observant, what is that? See, any vector space we know must have theta, the additive identity, right? And therefore, what does it mean? This V consists of only the so-called additive identity. That is the zero vector. Right? So, usually one says this as zero. Okay? But zero need not be zero. It could be anything. So, if you like a dog, you could be dog. Surely you can make it into a vector space. Yeah? Okay, P, R, P. Just for fun, try to understand. Okay? You could have put a sun here, then sun plus sun will be sun. S-U-N sun. Okay, now we want to go into slightly more abstract example, so brace yourself. Okay, suppose V is a vector space. Okay. And W is any set, right? Suppose, also assume if there is a bijection from V to W. Right? You understand this? Right. Now I claim, okay, I can make W into a vector space. Right? V is a vector space, W is any set. What all I know is there is a bijection between V and W, which is same as saying there is a bijection from W to V or V to W. Yeah? So I can make into space. So let me draw a picture and explain. Then we'll go into details. So this is a vector space B. Okay. And this is my W. Okay. So let me denote my vectors here in this kind of notation in the color scheme. And these things I will denote by different color scheme. Right? Okay, keep this in mind. I will give it in a minute. Okay. Now there is a bijection. There is a bijection from V to W. Now suppose this is your W1 and this is your W2. Then I have to define W cross W to W. That means I have to tell you what is W1 plus W2. Right? Now, since F is a bijection, I know there is a unique V1 so that F of V1 is W1. And similarly, there is a unique V2 so that F of V2 equal to W2. You understand that? Yeah. So, let Vi be the unique elements of V so that F of Vi equal to Wi. I equal to 1, 2. Right. Now, once I'm in V, V1 plus V2 will be a vector. Let us call it V3. Okay. Don't think of your parallelogram, law of addition, etc. That's not important for me. You understand that? This is V1 plus V2. This, can I do that? Yes. Because in a vector space, I can add two vectors. I will get a third vector. Call it V3. Right? Now under F, V3 goes to some W3. You understand? Now I define W1 plus W2 equal to F of V3. What is F of V3? It is F of, what is V3? F inverse of W1 plus F inverse of W2. This. But this is slightly more intimidating. Don't worry about that. What all you have to do is think about this picture. For W1, take the pre-image V1, unique pre-image. W2, take the unique pre-image V2, add them. And map this new vector, V1 plus V2, into a vector. So I define... Okay, w1 plus w2 equal to f of v1 plus v2. That's it. You understand? But what is w1? It is f of v1 plus f of v2. Follow that? This is a definition. The left side w1 plus w2 is defined by f of v1 plus v2. Okay? Right? And similarly, don't worry about whether it satisfies p1 to p4. I have to check whether it satisfies p1 to p4. Okay, at present we will not bother about it, but we have defined an addition. Okay, next thing, how will I define scalar multiple? Can somebody come up with this? Suppose w is in w, t is a scalar, how will I derive d times w? What should be the definition? Think about. So I have a v here, sorry, w here. Therefore, what do I know? There is a unique v such that f of v is w. Now v is a vector space, t is a scalar, therefore v goes to some tv. You understand? So map tv under f, you will get some vector. That vector will be tw. Yeah, this is t, okay, f of t times v, where w is t times v. Sorry, w is f time, f of v. Do you understand this? Again, go through. Don't worry about this. The symbols may look a little more intimidating, but the picture is easy. Start with the w, look for the free image v, and multiply it by a scalar t. I get a new vector tv, map it under f, so I'll get f of tv. Therefore, what do I define? So t times w equal to f of tv. W f of v. So I am defining t f of tv. So keep these two things in mind. Okay. This and this. Okay. Do you understand this? Go back, pause, review, and then proceed. Look at this geometric picture. It will immediately help you how to write this. Now the verification is a different issue. We'll come to that. Okay. Okay, now let's look at very specific examples. Okay, now let's look at R. We know it's a vector space over itself, right? This is a vector space over itself, like Rn. You understand? Now let's look at my W to be all positive reals. Can you think of this your B? Can you think of a bijection from B to W? I'm sure all of you know that. Yes? Right. What is that? Let me denote elements of B by the vector. Okay, let me denote by B itself. Okay. Right? No, I think it will be easier if I use T and X rather than V and W in this case. Okay? So let me denote elements of V as R, S, T, etc. Here the elements of W as X, Y, Z, etc. Okay? Right. So what is the obvious map? F of T equal to e power T, that is exponential of T. For any T real number, you define f of t to be this. All of you know this is a bijection. What is the inverse? Inverse is log, natural logarithm from w to v. Take any x here, map it to log x. You understood that? That is, for any x here, the pre-image is log x. You understand that? For every x in W, the unique pre-image is log x. Or as Americans would write, natural logarithm in ln x. I will write log. I got used to it. Okay. This is a bijection. Do you understand this? Now let us put our thing into F thing. Now suppose I have an X and Y in W. What is that I want to define? I want to define X. Okay, let me write X plus Y in a slightly different notation because they are real numbers. So I don't want to say this is the ordinary addition. You understand that? I want to define this new addition on W. How will I define? Let's go back. What did I do? Start with W1, W2, look for their pre-images. So if you give me X and Y, what are their pre-images? Okay, for X, it is unique T so that e power T is X. That is same as saying that T is log X. You understand? Therefore, for W1, that is X, it will be log X. For Y, it will be log Y. Do you understand that? Therefore, start with X and Y. Then what should I do? Look for the pre-image. Pre-image of X is log X. And pre-image of Y is log Y. What do I do then? In R, take log X and log Y. Then for I can add log X plus log Y. This makes sense because this is sum of two real numbers. Then what did I do? I added W1, V1 and V2. I got V1 plus V2 and map V1 plus V2 under F. You understand this? Yeah. W1 plus W2 is F of V1 plus V2. Do you follow that? Don't lose heart. Therefore, under this map F, namely exponential map, where will it go to? It will go to e power log x plus log y. But what is that? It is e power log x into e power log y. But what is this? This is x into y. So my x star y, ordinary multiplication of two real numbers, positive real numbers. Okay. Pause. Review. Proceed. So whatever you want to do, start in the dom range, take the pre-image, do whatever you want to do in the vector space here, and the resulting vector, map it under F. That's all you got. W1 plus W2, the pre-images are V1, V2. Add them, V1 plus V2. Therefore, W1 plus W2 will be F of V1 plus V2. Is that clear? Right. We will verify these things, okay? Don't lose heart. Now, the next thing. Suppose T is a scalar, then I want to define T star of X, where X is a vector in W. That is a positive real number. I have to define. Okay. How was it defined? Look for X, look at its pre-image in the vector space, that is log X. Right? X, the pre-image is log X. And then what do? You multiply with ordinary scalar multiple of this. In real, okay, R is a vector space, and therefore the scalar multiple of T of this vector will be T times log X. Ordinary multiplication of two real numbers. Do you remember that? Okay. Then what should I do? Look at it under the image F. What is F? It is exponential. Therefore, it is e power T log X. But what is e power T log X? It is X power T. Usually to make it easy, I can assume alpha is a real number, then you will see log X, alpha log X, e power alpha log X, that is X power alpha. Because usually you use X power alpha, right? That's why. Is that clear? Therefore, T star X is X power T. You understood? Have you understood this? So let us just write it. X and Y are positive reals. Then I am defining a new addition. Definition is ordinary multiplication of two real numbers. This is ordinary product of two real numbers. And alpha star x, where alpha is a real number, alpha star x by definition is x power alpha. Do you understand this? So I have defined both the operations where on W, what I want to check it, it's a vector space. I have to check whether it's a vector space. Let us do that. So what are the things I have to check? The first thing is commutativity. That is, whether it's equal to this. But what is this? This is x times y. What is this? This is y times x. Are they equal? Yes. Therefore, commutativity is 1 is 2. Right? This is P1. And let us look at P2. Or P2, what is that I have to check? X of y of z, whether it's equal to x y of z. But what is this? This is x plus y. What is y z? Y plus z. This is y times z. Okay, notice that this is also a positive number, this is also a positive number. Right? But what is this? This is by definition x into y z. Right? Multiplication of these two real numbers, x times y z. But what is this on the right side? This is x y direction z. Note again, notice that x and y are positive, therefore x y is positive, this is a positive number and z is a positive number. Then I have to do the new addition there, new addition. Okay, don't be intimidated, I call it addition. Okay, but what is this? This is nothing other than x y times z. What do I want to know? Whether these are equal? Are they equal? Yes, this is because associativity of the multiplication in R. Okay, therefore the associativity of the new vector addition in W is true. Yeah. Now you have to look at P3. What is P3? I have to look for a theta so that x plus theta equal to x. This must be true for whether there exists x, whether there exists theta so that x plus theta equal to x for every x in W. Right. But what is x plus theta? It is x times theta. That must be equal to x. Remember, theta must be in W. Therefore, it's non-zero. X is also non-zero. Therefore, what do you conclude? The theta must be 1. Do you understand that? And this theta is what we call zero vector. You understand? So, most of the textbooks and teachers will say the zero vector need not be zero. It could be some non-zero number. This is the example they will give. Now you see that how it comes. Yeah, usually in the textbook, what they will do is they will say define among positive real numbers this and this, and verify it's a vector space. But how they thought of this, that is not clear. Now what we have done, we have shown why we define these two operations, the so-called vector addition and scalar multiplication on positive real numbers. Why did we define? Okay, that is explained. The secret behind this is defined. How is it defined? By this trick. If V is a vector space, W is any set. If there is a bijection from V to W, I can make W into a vector space. Remember, the vector space structure of W will depend upon the bijection. The bijection is different because there may be many bijections. Do you understand? V to W. Right, depending upon this bijection F, I have defined W1 plus W2. If you give me some other bijection G, then that will be different. Okay. You can verify all these things with a concrete example. I'll come to it in a minute. You understand? Now, what is P4? P4 is for every X in W, I want to know that there is a Y in W. So that what happens? X. Y equal to theta. But what is xy? This is xy. This is equal to 1 is what I am asking. So what is your y? So the additive, the so-called additive inverse, that is vector inverse of x is multiplicative inverse. You understand that? The multiplicative inverse. Yeah. So we have verified P1 to P4. Okay. Now let's look at S1. What is S1? S1 said if I have S plus T star X, whether it equal to S star X. Okay. You understand? Now what? And you will say T star of X, but this is not ordinary addition. This is a vector in W. This is a vector in W, therefore this addition is the addition in W. Keep that in mind, otherwise you may make some mistake. Yeah. Now what is this by definition? This by definition is x to the power s plus t. Now what is this? This is s star x is x power s. And what is this addition? This is x power t. And what is this vector addition in W? That is ordinary multiplication. Right? And are they equal? By law of exponents, x plus x power s plus t is same as x power s into x power t. Therefore, this is true. You follow that? Is it interesting? Okay. Now let's do S2. What is S2? S2 is s plus x plus. Now, remember that this is a t. Okay, let me make it. T is a real number. X and Y are positive real numbers, which is in the vector space W. And therefore, the sum is going to be the sum of W. Right? Okay. Now, what is this by definition? I have to check whether this is equal to T. This must be star. I forgot. T star of X plus T star of Y. But what is T star of X? This is X power T into Y power T. Yeah? Now, what is this by definition? This is T star of what is X vector sum Y, the new sum, that is XY. This is a positive real number. Therefore, T star of this real number, what is this? This is XY to the power T. And what do I want to know? Whether these are equal. Are they equal? Yes. Therefore, we have proved S2. Right? Now, S3, I leave it to you and maybe, okay, I will do that. What is that ST I have to do? That is ST star of X. Okay. Whether equal to S of T star of X. You understand this? This is S3. Now, what is this? This is X of ST. Yeah. But what is this? This is S star of, what is T star of X power T? And what is S star of this Pauchy number? This is XT to the power S. So what do you want to know? Whether they are equal. Are they equal? Yes. Now let's do S4. That is very easy. We want to say 1X, whether equal to X. Yeah, but what is this? This by definition is x power 1. Therefore, it's equal to x. So that's also true. So what I have checked? I checked this. The positive real numbers under this vector addition and this scalar multiplication is a vector space. Are you happy? Yeah. So what is very interesting? The addition is not addition. And scalar multiplication is exponentiation. That is T star X is X power T. And the additive identity is not zero. The zero vector is one. Okay. Have fun. Okay. Pause. Review, proceed. Now let's look at one more example. I will leave a lot of verifications to you so that you become comfortable. This is slightly easier than the last example. Okay. And also, do you remember I told you, if F and G are two distinct bijections of V to W, then the vector space structure on W got via using F, and the vector space structure on W got by using G may be different. That is, W1 plus W2 with respect to F may be different from W1 plus W2 we got using G. You understood? As easy example can be got from here. I will not go into all the details because now you should be confident to do such things. Now let my V equal to R and W is also equal to R, right? So there is a natural bijection, but that's not the bijection I want. The bijection I want is, let me write B to W, is T going to T plus 1. As usual, I'll denote the elements of V as R, S, T, etc. and the elements of W as X, Y, Z, etc. You understood that? Yeah? I'll go quick. So let X, Y belong to W. Then what is the pre-image? The pre-image is X minus 1. Right, X equal to T plus 1, that means T must be X minus 1. Therefore, five, the pre-image for Y is Y minus 1. So what should I do? If I want to define X plus Y, I look at the pre-image of X and pre-image of Y, I add them. What do I get? In R, I have to add. What is the addition? That is X plus Y minus 2. Then what should I do? I push it under F. I have to look at F of this. But what is this? X plus Y minus 2 plus 1, that is X plus Y minus 1. Therefore, I define it to be X plus Y minus 1. You understand? Now, suppose you define T to be T, it to be T minus 1, you can do something similar, okay? This is the exercise. You understood this? Right. Now, how do I define scalar multiplication? Suppose alpha is a scalar. I want to define alpha star of X. How do I define? X goes to X minus 1. And this area in the vector space B, therefore alpha into X minus 1 makes sense. What is this? This is ordinary product of two real numbers, which is alpha X minus alpha. Now what do I have to do? I have to look at its image under F. But what is that? Alpha X minus alpha plus 1. Therefore this is alpha X minus alpha plus 1. You see that how complicated it looks? Yeah? So notice these two things. This is all we need. Okay? Right. I'll just show how to check one or two things. Okay, you can check whether X plus Y equal to Y plus X, whether X plus Y plus Z is the associative is true, etc. I'm interested in finding what is the additive identity. What is the theta? So that means X plus Y theta must be equal to X, right? But what is X plus theta? Let us look at the definition. That is X plus theta minus 1 must be equal to X. So what does this imply? This implies theta minus 1 must be 0. That implies my theta must be 1. You understand that? Therefore, the theta is 1. Right? Then next question is, what is the additive? Inverse. Suppose you give me X in W. Okay. I want X, okay, Y must be equal to theta, right? That additive inverse of X is what I want to know. Now, what is X plus X vector with some Y? According to us, this is X plus Y minus 1. Notice that these are all odd, the usual arithmetic operations in real numbers, and this equal to 1. What is theta? Theta is 1. Therefore, what should be y? This implies y must be equal to 2 minus x. Do you understand this? That means, let us check. What is x plus 2 minus x? According to us, this is add both of them and subtract. 2 minus x minus 1, that is 1, which is your theta. So this is correct. Okay, I'm going fast, but don't give up. Okay, pause, review, proceed if you aren't worried. Now let's look at scalar multiplication. Suppose alpha is a scalar. Okay, we had already defined alpha star of x. What is it? It is alpha x minus alpha plus 1. Am I right? Yeah. What are the things I would like to check? Let us just, as a sample, I'll do 1 or 2. First, alpha equal to 1. Is 1 star x. What is this? 1 star x is x minus 1 plus 1. Because alpha is 1. You understand? Therefore, x. So, I got it. Yeah? So, 1 star x is 1. Now, let us look at alpha plus beta star of x. I have to check whether it is equal to alpha star of x plus beta star of x. Yeah. Now, what is alpha plus beta star of x? That is alpha plus beta into x minus alpha plus beta plus 1. I am using this alpha star x. In place of alpha, I have alpha plus beta. Therefore, alpha plus beta into x minus of alpha minus beta. This is that okay? Make sure you follow that. Okay, don't give up so soon. Now let's look at what is this alpha star x. This is alpha x minus alpha plus 1 plus beta x minus beta plus 1. Yeah. But notice that this is a mistake I am doing here. This must be the sum here. What is the sum here? X plus y. X vector sum x plus y minus 1. Do you understand that? So this alpha star fx is alpha x minus alpha plus 1. And beta star x is just plus 1. Then what should I do? Add, call this as something. Or let us say z1 and z2, then z1 plus z2 minus 1. Do you understand? These are ordinary real numbers thing. Therefore, minus 1. But what is that? Alpha x plus beta x is alpha plus beta x. And minus alpha minus beta. And this is 1 plus 1 is 2. And 2 minus 1 is 1. So these are equal. You understand that? Yeah, so similarly you can check other properties, and just for fun you don't have to check anything, but try to see, for if you use the bijection g, how do you define x plus y and how do you define alpha star of x with respect to g. Yeah, and then so that you can see the vector addition x plus y with respect to f, if you want call it f, and define with g with respect to y, and check whether these two numbers are the same. They are real numbers, right? That will be fun. I hope you understand what I am saying. Okay, so x plus f y, I define it to be x plus y minus 1. I make it correct. Yeah, right. Now do check with respect to g, what should this be? Okay, what is the pre-image of x in that? What is g? It is good. G is x minus 1. Therefore, pre-image will be x plus 1. And what is the pre-image of y? It is y plus 1. So what do I have to do? I have to add them. X plus y plus 2. Then what should I do under f? That is going to be x plus y. Do you understand this? Now check this. And so on. Okay. Please go through. This may be very, very demanding, but you will thank me later, because it prepares you to abstract thinking and abstract algebra and linear algebra in the truest sense. Okay, it's not mere computations alone. You should also try to think a little more abstract way. So I hope all of you enjoyed this, discuss with this, play with it. Okay, if you give a new toy to a child, okay, it doesn't read a manual. It doesn't wait for the parents to tell how to use it. What does it do? It begins to play and it begins to explore the toy. It plays with the toy, perhaps breaks it, but understands it. Okay. So even in mathematics, when you come across a new concept, that's what you should do. Don't be afraid. Play with it. Make mistakes if necessary. You will learn. Okay. All the best. Have a good day.